back. Well, who really knows? Who can draw that conclusion until we officially know the extent of the injury?
Well, you don't want to run around with your foot in your mouth. You look like Bischoff. But being resilient over the years is one thing, but the years take its toll. And if Savage would have acted like half the man he is, he wouldn't have joined the New World Order in the first place.
All good points, Larry, but the fact is he did, and the fact is this has happened to him, and who knows why. Well, the crowd erupts here as they hear the music of the NWO.
They're not erupting, they're leaving. Turn off the stupid music.
Norman Smiley in this one-on-one matchup here on WCW Monday Night Club.
There's a couple of guys that would never think of stabbing anybody in the back.
No, that's all they think about. As a matter of fact, they would stab each other in the back given half the chance. And that's the paranoia that's running through the NWO amidst this power struggle that we saw just moments ago in our video feature here on Nitro.
Well, Conan and Norman Smiley, certainly no strangers to each other. They've been tag partners in the past. They've been rivals. Norman Smiley, very experienced in so many varied styles. He was born in England, currently lives in Mexico City. He can certainly wrestle the Lucha Libre style, the European style, even submission techniques. Should be a very even matchup here against Conan.
Yeah, but don't forget, Smiley's got to keep his eye on Vincent standing out there. That's two jobs in one right there.
Slowly back to the corner now as Conan tries to...
Can you wrestle with jewelry on? Just choke him with it.
This is almost a homecoming for Conan, originally from the Miami area, of Cuban descent, and of course making, well, turned himself into the number one star, professional wrestling-wise, in Mexico. Quite
Cuban,
an accomplishment.
No wonder I can't talk to anybody down here.
Oh, look at this, would you?
There you go.
Now, of course,
he pulled his head.
Stop it. Conan, obviously, a member of the NWO. And, you know, you heard the comments on our video package from Kevin Nash. And those were the same comments that Savage had said, you know, earlier back on an edition of Thunder when we were in Columbus, Ohio, about so many people wanting to stab Hollywood Hogan in the back. And when you mention that to Hogan, you notice how his expression, his demeanor completely changes.
He's probably going down the checklist, wondering who he was talking about, running names through his mind.
Yep, Smiley isn't smiling. See, that's what Smiley's got to watch out for. He's got it.
Front face lock, front chancery, if you will, across the bottom rope. You know, I've talked about so many of the great title matches coming up in tonight's program. Diamond Dallas will defend the U.S. heavyweight title tonight. Chris Jericho, the cruiserweight belt. Oh, we have seen the TV belt on the line. There also, fans, is our big feature bout in hour number three, where the world title will be contested. Now, I was handed this note for our hour three main event, and this one is going to knock you completely off your chair. Are you ready for this?
Sting's going to defend the world's title tonight?
Tonight. And guess who it's going to be against on this program?
Tell us.
Kevin Nash of the NWO. WCW officials.
For the title?
Have signed this one for the title tonight. You know, each and every time we come out to Nitro, I keep thinking, what great match are they going to sign? And they top themselves, the championship committee, each and every week with such great matches. World title on the line.
And what an opportunity for Nash to split the New World Order down the middle.
Yeah, let's say if Kevin Nash wins the world title. Okay, how is that going to impact what happens at Spring Stampede? And what about the injury to the Macho Man Randy Savage? How's that going to impact Spring Stampede? Just when you think you have all the answers, there are more questions piled upon you each and every week.
Wonder what Hollywood Hogan thinks about Kevin Nash getting that title shot.
Oh, boy. Hey, how about that? And we understand Hollywood Hogan is in the building somewhere. Roddy Piper's in the building somewhere. You know the Giant's going to face Scott Steiner a little bit later on. Miami is going to just light up here tonight, guys, with Sting and Kevin Nash for the world title. Look at this.
Well, Conan knows how to hurt you in that ring. Look at where he's got his ankle across the back of the neck of Smiley, pulling up on the Smiley's ankle with a lot of pressure on the small of the back. Smiley is not feeling good.
Driving the shin across the head, stepping on one arm, pulling back the other arm as Conan is back on the attack once again, sending Norman Smiley in to the ropes. Leapfrog goes Conan. Conan hugs him.
Oh my goodness! Dropped him on his head with the cradle DDT.
Did he ever?
Ow.
That's always a prelude to that tequila sunrise submission hold of his, and here it is. And quickly, Norman Smiley taps out.
Can you blame him?
Not at all. I'm amazed that he has the presence of mind to even tap on the mat here. So a win for the New World Order in this matchup here on WCW Monday Nitro. And later on tonight, a member of the NWO and the persona of the big, sexy, giant killer, as he calls himself, Kevin Nash, against Sting for the world title. That's all still to come here, and hopefully a condition update on the Macho Man Randy Savage, and maybe we'll see the footage that J.D. talked about earlier on.
Smiley had a hard time here. He had to keep his eyes on Vincent. And right there, Conan caught him, hooked him, turned him upside down, dropped him right smack on his neck. I'm surprised Smiley was conscious, but he had enough left in him to tap out. That was the smart thing to do.
So a big win for the New World Order. And ladies and gentlemen, as we first went on the air tonight, we were all shocked with this scene. Ambulances arriving to the Miami Arena. The Macho Man.